कहत कबीर सुनो भाई साधो, कहत कबीर सुनो भाई साधो, अरे कहत कबीर सुनो भाई साधो,
अरे कहत कबीर सुनो भाई साधो।
साहब मिले सबूरी में,
अरे साहब मिले सबूरी में,
मन लागो यार फकीरी में, मन
I may material in this moment be not so bad that I have this privilege to go and pursue with spirituality. But his friend said that I have to work from morning to evening and I cannot afford to be engaged in this kind of things that you are. And,
but spirituality is not a, not something separated from daily life.
Mm.
So am I not working right now?
Yes.
Remember yesterday I asked, how will you meditate while driving, while swimming, while eating, while cooking, while running your shop? So meditation and spirituality are integrated with daily living. They are not something separate. It's not as if you have to find separate time for spirituality.
Yes, I've been doing all the, I've been like two selves. During the day I function, then I search for these moments when I have for myself to be
no,
and then I feel so bad that I have to return to this every day.
You'll keep feeling bad then. In whatever you are doing, you keep observing, you remain committed to the truth, and then your actions are guided by the truth. That's what he also means here, no? That with the right attitude, you can be anywhere.
Mm-hmm.
And whatever you are doing, just.
So not so important to find the real thing for me.
See, that's a hypothetical question.
Practical problem. Because I finished this medical school, so now I'm a doctor. I studied really hard to do this.
Okay.
But now I worked in surgery for 1 year, and I was burned out because I couldn't do it anymore.
Okay.
And now I switch to easier speciality, this physical and rehabilitational medicine. But still, I'm not quite sure if this is the right for me. And but I'm starting work in the 1st May.
Actually, when we allow life to make decisions for us, then we get the best decisions.
Yes. So I already made this decision, but now yes.
You know, even now, you just remain committed to your peace. And life will by itself take you to the right places, all the right places.
Mm-hmm.
You need not decide whether you have made the right decision, whether this change of stream is the right thing for you. Life has a way of guiding everybody. You just remain faithful and committed.
To this moment now.
To knowing the truth, to being in touch with yourself. Most people like to deceive themselves. Don't deceive yourself.
Mm.
That's all.
Often he speaks how it's wrong identification. We identify with the body. Actually, but yesterday you spoke that we are this body. So we cannot ignore it, but he speaks a bit different.
You know what happens is that when this stuff is being said, it's nice to read and hear.
Mm.
But it should not be forgotten that it is the eyes that are reading this book.
Mm.
It is the body that is holding this book.
Mm.
So that simple and direct fact that even to read this I must be a body, that fact must not be ignored.
But it is pointing backwards in this other direction.
Yes, but to go backwards you must start from where you are.
Mm.
And as one is a body, and then one starts from there and tries to explore the truth. See, he is showing where you have to go. I am showing where you are standing. He is showing that you are the pure self, the Atman. I am showing you believe yourself to be the body. So, these are two ends of the same thing. Are you getting it? We believe ourselves to be the body.
Sometimes I have this feeling, it's just no, at the time also this mountain and this river. And
even that is the body, something material. So that's our immediate fact. Without the body, without your eyes, or without your skin, is there any mountain?
No.
If you cannot touch, see, hear, feel, or think about the mountain, is the mountain really there?
When I close my eyes, it's gone.
It's gone. Huh? And if the memory and the name and everything is wiped out from your brain, then you can't even imagine. So even that is the body. So,
and ultimately it's illusory, right?
It's
ultimately it's illusory.
It's like a dream. We cannot say it is illusory in the beginning. Maybe later on it will be proven that it is illusory. But as we are right now, it appears to be real. So my insistence is that we first of all accept that for us the body, the mountain, the universe are real. And when you accept that, then it is possible to move to another point. But we cannot think of that point in advance. That point comes a little later. And that point will never come if we first of all do not honestly acknowledge our current situation. The current situation is that I'll take this cup of tea, I'll gulp this down my throat because the throat is feeling bad. I'm looking at it, it's got a color, it's got an aroma, and all of that is a bodily perception. So given all this, it would be hypocritical of me if I say I'm not the body. If I'm not the body, who is drinking the tea? If I'm not the body, who is looking at the color? But the more you settle into this observation that I am the body, the more you settle into this, the more it is possible for you to step further. But one should not try to bypass.
Yes, I was doing this for, I've been reading this for 4 years and trying to go directly into this.
You cannot bypass. Yes, shortcuts are not possible. You have to honestly start from where you are. I'm full of hatred. But somebody comes and tells me, you know, unconditional love is your nature. And I start saying that, unconditional love is my nature, unconditional love is my nature. What is the fact?
The
mind is full of hatred. The mind is full of separation, repulsion. So just by saying that unconditional love is my nature, you will not come to unconditional love. First of all, start with all the rubbish and hatred and violence that is there in the mind. When you encounter the fact of the violence, then maybe it will be possible to come to love. But you cannot bypass it. Ravana Maharshi might know that love is your nature, but do you know that love is your nature? These are Ravana Maharshi's observations. Love may be his nature as he knew it. For us, what is our nature? Violence and hatred. So let us start honestly from there, not from where Ravana Maharshi is standing.
But he would also always point his disciples directly. He would also, to whom is the hatred, he would ask. And then and so, they have to look to whom, and actually they then they see that there are no...
You know, this question, who am I, is not an easy question to ask. It's not an easy question to ask because the answer is already there with us. What's your name?
Sasha. Sasha.
So who am I is answered. Now, what is the point in asking who am I again and again?
Yes, this Muji, he...
It's rubbish.
All the time he does it. Who am I?
Ask who am I. Now you already have 200 answers ready for who am I. Which country do you come from?
Yes.
Which country?
Slovenia.
Slovenia. So I am a Slovene. I am a doctor. I am a male. I am a resident of the earth. I am a young man. I'm a Jew or a Hindu or a Christian.
But there is someone observing all this.
See, tell me seriously. When you say all this, do you feel that somebody is observing all this, or are you really entrenched in that identity? When you say you are a man, don't you feel like a man? Honestly.
Not in this moment.
In this moment, what do you feel like?
Like nothing. It's like this river and all.
So I am the one who feels like nothing. I am the one who feels like the river. Who am I still answered? When the question has still been already been answered, what is the point in asking who am I? The honest approach will be to say, not to say who am I, but to say, I am Sasha. See, one asks the question only when one does not know the answer. Is that not commonsensical? If I ask you, where are the keys? Where are the keys? Then first of all, I should not know where the keys are. It's not clear. If the keys are here and I'm carrying them and I still keep asking, where are the keys? What does that mean? That means I'm just joking or making a fool of everybody. When I already know so much about who I am a seeker, I'm a spiritual man, I'm a shopkeeper, I'm an old man, I'm a lover of good food. So I am has been answered in 1,000 ways by us already. Now when it has been answered in so many ways, there is no point in asking who am I. Who am I comes after all these identities have been negated and crushed down. So, I think that I am this cup of tea. And I have been successfully believing that I am this cup of tea. First of all, this has to be emptied. Now it is empty. Now I have no identity left. Now I can wonder, oh, so I am not this cup of tea, then who am I? So that question comes at level 3. Level 1, I am this cup of tea. I am Sasha, I am a doctor, I am a male. That is state 1. State 2, question these identities and see their falseness. So state 2 is emptying of this cup. Now that the cup is empty, now you can ask who am I? That is state 3. But without taking the student through state 1 and state 2, if you immediately take him to state 3, then you are just making a hypocrite of yourself and the student. Is that not clear? If I already know who I am, then how can I ask this question? And don't we already know who we are? So first of all, this has to be emptied. First of all, our existing identities have to be shown as false. First of all, they have to be shown as false, and they can be shown as false only in light of our daily observation.
When you say who am I, and you say Sasha, so one time Sasha is 5 years old, and Sasha is 10 years old.
You are saying this right now. When in the shop he is standing and somebody asks him Sasha, does he say, oh, right now I am Sasha, but once Sasha was 5 years old, once Sasha was 10 years old? All of this is theory. Theory that does not work in real life.
So then,
in that moment, do you remember this, that I am not Sasha?
But if I already had the experience that this Sasha dissolved, and
if you already have this experience that this Sasha dissolved, then when I say Sasha,
you should not answer it, but it was experience, and then Sasha came back, and then
Sasha is usually back. Sasha is usually there. So we must start from the reality of our lives. The reality of our lives is that we are Sasha. We are Sasha. And it does not sound too grand. Asking who am I looks so nice. Oh, who am I? But why are you asking this? It is important only in the context of seeing that what you believe yourself to be causes grief to you. I believe myself to be Sasha and Sasha is suffering. So I drop Sasha. So I empty the cup. Now when the cup is emptied, then I can wonder that all the old identities have gone. What am I left with? Now I can ask, who am I? But not before emptying of this identity.
But how to empty the identity?
By seeing that it causes me suffering.
Maybe I can do this for a million of incarnations.
Yes,
to empty.
No. In fact, in the name Sasha itself, all other identities are contained. If you can empty yourself of Sasha, then you don't need to empty yourself of your identity as a European, as a male, as a young man. Because Sasha contains so many of them.
I know that people say, I am Sasha. There are one who says that, and one who says that there are two of me. Then I cannot say I am Sasha. Because then
this
Sasha
second,
is an object. Okay. I am the subject.
This second one, how do you know him? You are saying there is a second one that is watching the first one. Right? You are saying there are two of you, and the second one is watching the first one.
Yes.
How do you know the second one? First one you can know because the second one is watching him. Now how do you know the second one?
Which one? The watcher or
the watcher?
The watcher.
How do you know the second one? The watcher. First one you know because the watcher is watching him. How do you know the second one?
Because it's how does the eye see? It cannot be explained. It just is.
It's an intuition or it's a very subtle feeling.
So the eye is able to look at itself also, right?
Just in the mirror.
Just in the mirror, right?
But not like this. I cannot look at my eye. But I know that I see and there is just this thing.
So there is something that is watching the eye also.
Yes.
Eye is watching the mountain and there is something watching the eye also.
And I know this.
And that thing that is watching the eye, you know that thing also.
This is me. Really.
How do you know this?
By experience.
So there has. So then you are saying that there is an experiencer behind all of this. And if you are talking about him, then there is somebody watching the experiencer also. The real witness cannot be known, observed or talked about. When you say that you know Sasha, it is just one part of the mind watching another part of the mind. It is no observation, nothing. It is just like you are going to commit a theft and one part of your mind is watching you commit the theft and saying no, it is bad. This is not at all a case of witnessing. This is just a case of a divided, fragmented mind. When witnessing occurs, it is impossible for you to know that witnessing is occurring. Witnessing is known only by its effects. Not because, here am I working there and that is the witness watching me. Then who are you? You are the witness of the witness. But such stuff is usually dished out by teachers. That, you must see that you are witnessing something. If you are witnessing something, how will you see? To witness is to see all that which is happening, including the seeing.
So then this is the right, this is our real nature, and the other is changing, the other is
for
actually
us,
a fiction.
For us,
when searched it will disappear.
No, for us, only this strife, this tension, this fiction is real, and start from here only. The ego is not an illusion. The self, the Atman, is an illusion. The ego is our immediate reality. When you will be angry and fighting with someone, then I will come and say, anger is an illusion. You will beat me up as well.
But yes, but before 5 years ago I would do it. Now maybe very rarely because I can watch it. And I'm not saying that I never get angry or...
Is it possible to be disappointed and feel unfree and yet not be angry? But if anger is just a set of symptoms for us, then we can suppress those symptoms and act as if we are not angry. Usually you recognize that people are angry when they raise their voice, when their face goes red. Now you can suppress all these symptoms and anger can remain subdued in your mind. And you can very easily claim, I'm not angry. But if you're not angry, then why are you disappointed? Can anger and disappointment be separated? Where there is disappointment, there is anger. Where there is a frustration of desire, there is anger. But you can suppress the anger. And then claim that, no, I don't get angry anymore.
So then what is the approach? What is the thing to be aware of and to...
This cup of tea. This cup of tea.
In
that's the only thing.
This moment, that's all.
Yes, of course.
All to know.
Of course, yes. All the facts of our life are like an open book present to us through our actions, through our thoughts, and through our relationships. It's so easy to see who we are. I'm an insecure husband. I am an insecure husband. I'm a greedy businessman.
Many things, huh?
I'm a confused seeker.
And so what's the relevance?
Nothing. just be there with this and then see the magic. Just be there with this. So don't ask who am I. Say I am this. Otherwise it looks very amusing. Sasha is asking who am I. No, he's Sasha. I am Sasha asking who am I. When the postman comes to deliver a letter to your house and says, Sasha, do you say who am I? Then you say, I am Sasha. Then very quickly you become Sasha. Right? Then immediately you are Sasha. I am Sasha. But when you... Yes, or when you receive a check in your name.
Not a bill.
Yeah. Who is Sasha? Who is Sasha? Who am I? When you receive your check, then you do not ask, who am I? Then you say, I am Sasha. Yes, give that check to me. So it is very amusing and very kiddish to keep parroting this, who am I? Who am I? That question is only for the very mature seeker who has first emptied the cup. Once your cup is empty, then even without asking who am I, you are in that zone.
But what if you die before emptying the cup?
This question, this fear of death, is there only to the man that Sasha is. So remain with that man. See his fears, insecurities, his apprehensions. If you are not Sasha, will you still ask this question? If you are not Sasha, will you still ask this question? So this question is coming from the man that Sasha is. Watch this man and see how he lives, eats, breathes. It is not our nature to live in misery. If you watch that Sasha is attached to misery, then you will automatically drop the misery, because it is not our nature to remain miserable. Our nature is to have fun. Like everything in existence, we too all to have fun.
And how does one drop the misery so one is attached to?
By seeing that it is misery. If you call your misery as your religious duty, then you will not drop it. If you call your misery as your professional commitment, then you will not drop it. misery has to be called misery. There is something within you that cannot accept misery. Just like the small child who can never accept torture or boredom. It is not our nature to tolerate misery. But for that, you will first have to acknowledge that you are miserable. And from that acknowledgement rises an inner rebellion against misery. Once you fully and honestly admit to yourself, I am damn miserable, then a fire rises from within which burns the misery. It's a rebellion. It's a purification.
Which will override other concerns, such
yes,
as
of course.
I'm miserable
because of this, so that something may be preserved, so that the fellow may not feel bad. Then all the justifications for maintaining the misery are burned down.
But you finally just say it has to go.
Ah. And you say, misery is misery, no matter what.
Based on the trust.
And you need to have the trust that even after misery goes away, you're okay.
Why this line is so famous, who I am, and why so many people are finding the answer of this line?
This line is not so very famous or something. Well, the Upanishads talk of deham, koham, soham, naham.
Yes.
And they talk of what the self in a multifarious ways. Artharahito aham. Huh? Ramana Maharshi picked up one of them, Koham, who am I? And he would use that in his interactions with his people. Now after Ramana Maharshi, many people copied him. So you feel as if it is very famous, it is not that famous.
But was he successful with this approach?
Not very successful.
I have seen it in one of the line in IITs. Also the IIT t-shirt they have used, who I am.
This who am I is now famous only because it has become fashionable in the last 10-50 years. Otherwise, there are more prominent utterances also. Soham, for example, is a more significant and prominent utterance of the Upanishads. Soham means that am I.
And so if we emptied the cup, emptied ourselves, then what is the way to find out who I am?
Don't worry about that. You're going too far ahead.
So the first step is just to see who we are. See, I am miserable or whatever it may be.
Honestly, brutally honestly, very, very brutally honestly. I am a penny pincher.
Is that bad?
No, not bad. If you call it bad, then you'll suppress it. So just say, I am a penny pincher. I am.
All those traits have good and bad.
No bad, no good. No morality in any of this. I am a penny pincher.
And so?
So nothing else, but I am. Okay. Full stop.
That's
when
start there.
You come to this full stop, then the work of the magic begins. It's like a relay race. You know a relay race?
A what?
In which you pass the baton.
Relay
race.
Oh, yeah.
So there are four runners. The first one runs his course and then passes the baton. So your job is only to accept that you are this. I am Sasha. And then you pass the baton to somebody else. Now he will run the race. So you don't ask what will happen after that. You come to a full stop. But we are having a funny situation in which the first runner is thinking about the fourth runner. The question, who am I, is the fourth runner in the relay race. First of all, the first one has to run, then the second has to run, then the third has to run, only then the fourth can be activated. But we are not activating the first three and directly jumping to the fourth. Now the fourth won't run because the baton hasn't come to him. That is why this who am I method fails. It's not a bad method.
But what if someone is already at the third game?
Don't ask what if. Are you there? Have you emptied your cup?
Don't you empty it by saying that if there is a watcher, I'm not there? No.
Will you talk all this watcher stuff and other things? Had you not read about them? Seriously. It is all theory that is coming to us through books. Had books not told us this, we would have never used this language, right? I am the watcher, I am the witness, I am the observer. And theory does not help in practical life. Theory doesn't help you when your wife is shouting at you. Try theory then. Theory doesn't help you when you haven't paid your bills and they are sending you letters. Try theory then. Theory doesn't help you when your EMI is due and they are coming to take away the car.
At this point, does meditation have any value or...?
Only meditation has value.
What kind or how?
It leads to right action. It leads to right living.
Just sit peacefully.
No, no, not sitting peacefully. This is meditation.
Ah, okay.
This is meditation. Oh, no, not that meditation. No, 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 not that.
Satchitananda meditation.
No, no, not that. This is meditation.
So, maine isme padha ki jab hum 12 saal ke ya 14 saal ke hote hain to hamare upar dhan ko lagaa diya jata hai. Matlab hamari se consent bhi puchi jati hai ki aapko accept karna hai ki nahi karna, but forcefully it should be forced on us. So sir, kya matlab dharm ne jo hum log humanity ka fayda hua hai overall dekha jaye, agar dharm nahi hota to hum log uske bina jeena?
Ye sawal kalpanik hai. Dharm hai na? Dharm hai to ye main puchungi, nahi hota to kya hota? Dharm nahi hota to ye sawal bhi nahi hota. तो ये मत पूछो कि धर्म से क्या हुआ है क्या नहीं, ये देखो कि अभी स्थिति क्या है. हमको किताबी सवालों में ज़्यादा रुचि रहती है और अपने जीवन के जो बिल्कुल प्रस्तुत सम्मुख प्रश्न हैं उनके बारे में हम बात नहीं करना चाहते. मैं बताता हूँ हमारी ज़िंदगी की, यू नो व्हाट आर द रियल कंसर्न्स ऑफ आवर लाइफ. द रियल कंसर्न्स ऑफ आवर लाइफ आर, and that is what takes us so much of our time. Will she marry me? Will I get a promotion? Will I get admission in that university? When will I make my next million rupees? Is my wife seeing somebody else? Are they conspiring behind me? Is the office about to hire somebody else?
So the first step is really to see what's going on.
In reality, you are occupied in all this pettiness. But then you talk Paramatman and Koham and Sachidanand. This is sheer hypocrisy.
Yes.
Is it not? Is it not hypocrisy? The fellow is all the time aroused, scratching his balls and asking, ah, I'm Sachidanand. The fact is, you are a lusty animal, that's all. What is Sachidanand? Huh? You have gone to a temple and you are watching beautiful women there.
There is some truth in that.
There is a lot of truth in that. A lot of people go to temples just to watch nice women.
Mr. Satsang.
Yeah, Swar Satsang.
Satsang of stories.
Yes, yes. And tight pants. And yoga poses. And you are talking of the union between the mind and the Atman. And all your concern is to concentrate on her thighs. It sounds ugly, but it is ugly, and let's call ugly as ugly.
Is it ugly? So do you mean that?
Not bad.
Having those interests precludes or will or won't?
No, no, no. It is ugly to not to acknowledge these
things.
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
You have all the right to watch somebody's thighs. But to be watching somebody's thighs and saying that you have come for yoga, that is ugly. Because that is a lie. That is hypocrisy. That is fear.
If you then do the yoga, if you go for yoga.
Yes, of course. If you are saying that you have come for yoga, then...
Do yoga.
Do yoga.
Your attention should be...
Yes, of course. And if you have come to watch somebody's thighs, then you should have the honesty to admit that you have come to watch thighs. There's nothing bad about thighs. Thighs are thighs.
But just be honest.
Just be honest.
And then?
That's
too
it.
Soon.
Then pass the baton.
Just watch.
Just watch. And then stop and it's a relay race. Don't forget it.
No, what? Sorry.
You do your role
oh.
And full stop. That's all. Don't think too far ahead.
Is there anything wrong with just enjoying to be a cup of tea?
If it is enjoyable. If it is enjoyable.
Without suffering, you cannot empty it.
If you are not emptying, then are you suffering any less?
Sorry?
By not emptying, are you suffering any less? With the cup of tea full, is it not your cup of woes? It is not a cup of tea, it is a cup of suffering. And if it is not suffering, there is no need to empty it. If your cup is not full of suffering, then there is no need to empty it. It is not a compulsory thing that you must get rid of everything that you have. No, not at all. Only if it is causing you suffering.
But then you'll never come to the second stage.
You have no obligation to come to any stage. If you are all right where you are, then why must you go to any stage? There is no obligation to keep rising. It's, you know, it's almost like the corporate promotions. And. So in spirituality also, oh, level 3. The pyramid, you know. If you are all right where you are, why do you need to rise to any stage? Just be all right. Huh? And if there are things that are not all right, then empty them. Is that not very, very commonsensical? Whatever is all right, let that stay all right. And whatever is not all right, clear it.
How do we clear it?
How do you get rid of your stinking clothes? How do you get rid of them? A point comes when continuing to wear a stinking shirt is more of a suffering than suffering in the cold without the shirt. The point comes like that. When you say that I would rather take the cold in the chest, but I cannot take this stink anymore, this has to go, that is emptying. We don't need more promotions, we need more resignations. That's what we need. We need more people who can resign, who have the guts to. Don't feel so quizzed. It's actually absolutely simple. If the car is running nicely, let it run. If the car is cranky, making noises, then get some spare parts. That's all.